You should be doing stand-up.
But what would I do?
I'm not really no pimp. I ain't got no stable of hoes. I just created a character.
Dolemite Is My Name stars Eddie Murphy as comedian Rudy Ray Moore. And if you've seen the movie, which is streaming on Netflix right now, you know one of the standouts is Lady Reed, played by Davine Joy Randolph, who is with me now. Welcome.
Hi, thank you for having me.
All right, Lady Reed. She is a character.
I told you.
You sure do.
The singer, huh?
I get so nervous I had to hang on to the mic from not falling over. Butterflies all in my stomach.
You're funny.
You've talked about the responsibility you felt playing her.
Yeah.
Tell me more about that.
Well, I would say it started by, in my process for researching her and preparing to play this real life person, I was shocked and really disheartened to find there was little to nothing on her. No, yeah. Quite honestly, there's nothing on her.
Which is crazy.
It's like, insane,
yeah.
You know? And especially because I then posed the question, so why is there stuff on Rudy Ray Moore and not her?
Why is there stuff on the man?
Yeah, no, but for real, you know what I mean? Like, that's same period. They equally did just about the same amount of his movies. Why is there nothing? It then posed the responsibility of, this is the first time most people will know of her.
Do you know karate?
No, but I'm a fast learner. I can learn how to chop me a motherfucker.
Action.
You get to share some really incredible scenes with Eddie Murphy.
So I did not know that this was even an Eddie Murphy movie until my final callback.
Wow.
Which was a blessing because I wouldn't have been able to do anything. So the night before, I said to myself, okay, this is what we're going to do. You got 2 hours to take in that it is Eddie Murphy, and then it is over.
There is this really poignant scene between your two characters where you talk about seeing someone who looks like you on the big screen for the first time.
I'm so grateful for what you did for me, because I never seen nobody that looks like me up there on that big screen.
When was the first time you saw yourself represented on screen?
I do not mean this with any form of disrespect. I, in many ways, am still searching for myself, but I will say this. And this is not...
There's gonna be a lot of people who are gonna see you and see the, you know, see themselves.
I'll say this, I get as specific to say a black woman of color who is over a size 10. Because size in this industry has a lot to do with it. Mm-hmm. So for me, the size component, because I don't want people to be like, no, we got Viola Davis, we have Angela Bassett, we have this, we did. We absolutely do. But a woman of size to play a role in which she can be considered just a strong black woman, where it's not, or just a strong woman, or just a strong human being.
You are looking stunning in this movie.
Thank you.
Partly thanks to Ruth Carter, who did the costuming. It's that green dress. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Tell me, just stepping into this world with the fashion.
It was just a very collaborative experience. You know, we pulled actual vintage clothing, and you know, people's bodies changes over time and decades. So a size 16 in the 70s was a totally different size to what, you know, that would be now. And everything was custom, which was phenomenal. And we also picked certain pieces to be homage to different women during that time. Okay. Some of my hairstyles were nods to the late, great Diane Carroll, or, you know what I mean? Like, I'm the only woman. So we gotta like fill up this whole space. When you're past a certain size, even in the real world, shopping for clothes is very difficult. Don't you dare try to wanna be fashionable on top of that. So to have someone embrace me and encourage me to think outside the box and to want more and to even show off at that, like, that was just a good feeling.
You are Tony nominated. You are no stranger to the stage on Broadway. But how much needs to change on Broadway?
From what I remember, there's like a cyclical pattern in like a 5-year thing, right? So you'll get your like cool, like woke stuff, tends to be like a Lin-Manuel type piece that's ethnic or has predominantly female or something like that. And then they'll go super white and super like Rodgers and Hammerstein and Irving Berlin. You know what I mean? It's like it goes all the way back. In general, Like, it would be interesting if we stepped outside of, and again, show and reflect, you know what I mean? Or have multiracial and diverse cast and ensemble members. Because I know people are like, well, why haven't you gone back to theater? I very much so want to. Number one, I will say, I do think that they really need to improve and work on the pay for their actors, because Broadway is some of the most difficult work. And what you get paid for is in no way fair or comparable to what you would, you're basically giving up your life for art.
How's that?
I see no reason to do it again.
Wesley Snipes is going to be joining Eddie in Coming to America 2. Mm-hmm. So I want to know, what sequel do you want to be in with Eddie, of his movies?
Oh, it might be fun to be in Beverly Hills Cop. To be a cop with him, like a little buddy cop situation, be in the car with him.
Love this, you know, idea. I mean? The two of
you.
Yes. Love this. Can we have another duet, please?
Yeah.
Hear those, hear that beautiful singing voice?
Oh, thank you. Eddie, that's what we're doing, okay? I need another job. Beverly Hills Cop, please. Thank you.
Davine, this is such,
thank
this
you
is such
so
a
much.
Joy.
Thank you.
And you can watch Dolemite Is My Name streaming on Netflix right now.